Hey folks, this is Sebastian. Welcome to the follow-up video of our FeeFox Home Lab Challenge about rotation. If you haven't seen the challenge, watch the first video before watching this one, because this here is only the follow-up with some explanation and discussion. If you've done the experiment, you will have created a plot that looks like this. You've got the angular velocity on the x-axis and the radial acceleration on the y-axis, and your data followed something that looked like this. Now, what's this? Well, FeeFox also gave you a square plot, which means that on the x-axis there is the angular velocity squared and the radial acceleration is still on the y-axis, and here your data should have looked like a straight line. And this tells you that the original plot, the curved line, is actually a parabola, and which is just another fancy word for the relation that the angular velocity squared is proportional to the radial acceleration. And this already answers the first question I posed in this challenge, which was, what happens if you double the angular velocity? Well, if you double the angular velocity, then you would expect the radial acceleration to quadruple. We can visualize this in my sketch if I did it properly. So if we double the angular velocity, then we should have about 4 times the radial acceleration. Of course, you should also check this with your data. The second question from the challenge was, what happens if I repeat the experiment at a different radius? And we can do this with our experiment here. Because in our salad spinner we just have to add some padding to make sure that the phone is not stuck to the side but rotating at a smaller radius. By the way, if you had some trouble in your experiment with some vibration, it helps to add a second phone as a counterweight to make sure that your rotation is not too eccentric. So if we do this experiment now, first at a smaller radius, we again see our parabola, just like before. If we now change for a larger radius, we again see the parabola, but the values are much higher. It's simply scaled up. So obviously, the radius scales our parabola. We can have a look at the actual relationship, which is radial acceleration equals radius times angular velocity squared. And if we now think about this in terms of the square plot, well, then angular velocity squared is simply what's printed on the x-axis. And radial acceleration is still on our y-axis, and we've got a simple linear equation. And the radius in here just determines the slope of the straight line that we would expect in our plot. So this means, if we now have a look at the squared plot of the data of our experiment with 2 different radii, we would expect multiple straight lines, and that's what we actually see. So doing this experiment with a smaller radius simply means that we've got a lower slope for the straight line, and if we repeat the same thing with a larger radius, we simply have a steeper slope. Well, and if you don't want me to mathematically derive this relationship, that's all I have to say in this follow-up video. But don't worry, there will be another home lab challenge tomorrow. I hope to see you there again. Until then, stay healthy, see you soon.